Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. In this video, before we continue explaining the rest of the bone tools, we're going to review the tools we've learned so far with a practical example. Because to understand the new tools better, you need to have a solid grasp of the previous ones and have practiced them properly in a hands-on way. Alright, first we're going to learn the design tools together, and once we get a bit skilled in designing, we'll move on to character rigging. Keep in mind that if you don't know how to design characters, we're planning to release a character design course in the future. So before you forget, hit the subscribe button now because we'll be adding some really professional lessons to these tutorials later. But if you need a character for practice right now, you can download the same one I'm using from the link in the description or design your own using AI. We'll also upload a tutorial on that after these videos. The character you're seeing in this video was designed by me using DALLE with a well-crafted prompt. In the future, I'll be adding tutorials on DALLE and other AI tools for you, but if you need ready-made characters, you can check out Freepik. I've put the link in the caption so you can easily download any character you want. We're going to design, color, and rig this character together over a few sessions. When designing a character, each body part should be drawn on a separate layer to keep everything organized. In this session, we'll be designing the head and facial features. To start, we'll create a vector layer and name it. The first layer we're going to name is the head. To draw the character's head, we need to use the Add Bone tool. I'll select Add Bone and start drawing. You don't need to be too precise with the top part of the head since it'll be hidden under the hair. If you notice, the first and last points aren't connected, and that's because auto weld is turned off. So make sure to turn auto weld on and test it again. Now I'll start using the transform points tool to organize all the points so we have cleaner lines. Shadows are completely up to personal taste, and since we're still in the beginner topics, I won't take up too much of your time with them. In the upcoming videos and more advanced sections, after we've learned all the tools, we'll dive into shadows and the finer details of design. To design the hair, we create a layer named hair above the head layer. As you can see, the hair covers the face, so the layer needs to be above it. I'll create the layer, name it hair, and start designing it using the Add Bone tool. The key point here is that you don't need to be too precise at first because we'll clean up each layer after designing. This way you can work much faster. Alright, now we'll clean up the design we just created. Now we'll check everything again and add any missing parts to the hair to make sure nothing is left out. If you look closely, the eyebrow is positioned between the hair and the head, so naturally its layer should be placed between them too. I'll create a new vector layer between the head and hair, name it eyebrow, and start designing it. I just need to select the Add Bone tool, draw the eyebrow, and then clean it up. Now it's time to design the ear, so I'll pick the Add Bone tool and start drawing. I prefer to design the ears on two separate layers, one for the left ear and one for the right. Keep in mind that the more layers you use, the harder your work gets, but at the same time, it becomes much more professional and organized. To design the right ear, we don't need to go through the whole drawing process again. We just duplicate the left ear layer, rename it, select all its points, flip it, and place it in the correct position for the right ear. For the eyes, we'll follow the same process as the ears, design one eye first and then duplicate it. But there's a small difference this time. I'll design both eyes in a single layer. The only reason for this is to show you different ways of structuring your layers, so you know that you can either design them separately or keep everything in one layer. We'll do the same for the nose and mouth. As you know, these layers should be placed above the head layer, so I'll create them on top of the head and start designing. Just keep in mind that for the mouth, I'll only use a stroke. There's no need to draw a filled shape. In the next session, we'll design the body and hands together and go over the important details for drawing them. So if you're interested in animation, make sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel.